Welcome to Tech Chat, sponsored by Mouse Electronics, where we chat with engineering experts about the latest technical innovations that are shaping and reshaping our world. Today, we welcome Benjamin Damkroger, Strategic Marketing Manager for Integrated Conductor Current Sensors at Allegro Microsystems. Welcome to Tech Chat, Ben.
Hey, Jeff. Great to be here.
So, Ben, tell us about your topic and your agenda for today's Tech Chat.
Yeah, so today we're going to talk about current sensing alternatives to traditional shunt resistors and shunt resistor circuits. We'll explore specifically how magnetic current sensors offer compelling advantages over those shunt resistors and related circuits. So we'll talk about what are magnetic Hall effect integrated conductor current sensors, their advantages versus traditional shunt resistor circuits, and then finally, we'll end with a discussion on what devices are offered by Allegro Microsystems to replace these shunt resistor circuits.
Well, I'm excited to learn about this topic. In keeping with the agenda you just laid out, let's start with an overview of the different types of current sensors there are to choose from these days.
So this is an overview of the portfolio of current sensors offered by Allegro Microsystems, categorized into two main types. So on the left, we have integrated conductor current sensors for currents below 200 amps, and on the right are field sensors for currents exceeding 200 amps. Within each category, we have various package options to suit different application needs, including small outline packages, wide body packages, coreless PCB, and core-based SIP packages, and beyond for higher currents. This range of options allows us to address a wide spectrum of current sensing requirements for low power applications and high current, high isolation systems. But today we'll be discussing in specific the functionally isolated lower current devices in the QFN and EZ and EX packages on the left-hand side.
Now that we understand the types of current sensors and the type we're talking about today, could you give us an explanation of the basics of magnetic Hall effect current sensors and how they work?
Of course. So Hall effect current sensing works when current flows through a conductor. It generates a magnetic field around it. This is according with Ampere's law, where a magnetic field is proportional to the electric current flowing through a conductor. And so with the Hall effect, we're able to measure the voltage proportional to that magnetic field flowing through the conductor. And we amplify the Hall effect voltage to the output and essentially get a voltage output which is proportional to the current flowing through the conductor of the package. And this is all without directly and invasively including a shunt resistor in the circuit.
Thanks for that explanation. That paints a vivid picture for me of how these sensors work. Okay, now that we know the basics, let's set up the discussion. Could you briefly start by summing up how Allegro's current sensors are different from other current sensors available?
Current sensing can be done with several different technologies and topologies as shown here, ranging from using shunt resistors and amplifiers, shunt resistor and isolated amplifiers for where isolation is needed in high voltage applications, or using current transformers for high bandwidth and isolated applications. Those all can be used, but the Allegro current sensor, magnetic current sensors that we offer, integrate all of the capabilities of those sensors into a single integrated circuit package. And you can see we have either field or integrated conductor options, both using the same magnetic current sensing technology.
Excellent. Thanks for that overview. Now let's get into more details and specifics on the advantages magnetic current sensors have compared to traditional shunt resistor circuits.
Yes, so magnetic current sensors essentially provide a sweet spot between two extremes when looking for current sensing accuracy and low cost. So on the very high accuracy side for measuring very small currents in the milliamp range, there may be a need to go to a current sense amplifier with a shunt resistor, usually a larger ohmic shunt resistor. And then on the very low cost side, you may see op amps used on the low side, low voltage with op amps and shunt resistors. But in the middle, where we play with magnetic current sensors, is a sweet spot between these two extremes. and it offers a compelling balance of cost effectiveness, accuracy, and performance. So they're ideal for a wide range of applications. Some of the key advantages here include smaller size, fewer parts. So we have a BOM reduction and a shrinking of area, as well as integrated signal conditioning, lower power dissipation, and lower resistance. Our current carrying conductors tend to be low resistance. There's functional isolation because of the inherent magnetic construction of the devices and sensing topology. There's also better CMTI or better common mode transient immunity. Inline sensing for motor and PWM applications is made easier with our devices. And they're also higher bandwidth due to the lack of parasitic inductance in the shunt resistors, as well as our current sensors are offered in bandwidths up to 5 megahertz. The devices we discussed today are in the hundreds of kilohertz, but for applications that require high bandwidth, there are higher bandwidth devices available that Allegro offers.
Okay, so we have several advantages of magnetic current sensors listed here. So let's go through each one, one by one, starting with the advantage of smaller size and fewer parts required.
So this slide visually demonstrates the significant size advantage of magnetic current sensors over traditional shunt resistors. You can see at the bottom portion of the slide a comparison of our ACS71240 in its 3x3 millimeter QFN package versus the equivalent discrete solution, which is 120 millimeters squared with a 0.5 milliohm shunt. And so the size comparison here is significant, as well as the ACS37220, which is offered in a 4x4 QFN with a 0.1 milliohm EZ package. And this QFN package is 7.2 times smaller than even the equivalent shunt, not counting the amplifier and gain components as well as filtering components necessary. So there's a size benefit there, as well as what's highlighted at the top of the slide. You can see that there are components needed. So a shunt for one, two would be filtering components. Often low pass filtering components are needed here, as well as gain setting resistors and an op amp to do the actual amplification of the shunt resistor voltage. You can see that there are other options as well. Not always is a current sensor with an op amp constructed discretely. Sometimes current sense amplifiers are used, which integrate gain resistors, or integrated shunt devices that have shunt resistors, the gain setting resistors, and an amplifier integrated. But none of these include the filtering components. So the benefit of a magnetic current sensor is that it integrates all of these components into a single package while maintaining a very small size and low integrated conductor resistance for high current applications. This slide demonstrates some of the challenges of traditional shunt resistor-based circuits. One thing to mention is that Allegro Hall effect current sensors have built-in signal conditioning, so they address this key challenge. But with shunt impedance, it increases with frequency due to parasitic inductance in shunt resistors, causing sensitivity changes which require external filtering to maintain flat frequency response or flat gain over frequency. Our sensors integrate this signal conditioning and eliminate the need for external filters, ensuring accurate measurement across a wide frequency range. Another benefit of magnetic current sensors is lower power dissipation. So power dissipation is another critical consideration in current sensing, especially in power sensitive applications where heat dissipation and efficiency are of primary concern. This slide showcases the low power dissipation of Allegro's EZ package compared to traditional shunt resistors, particularly at high currents. So you can see here how common shunt resistors are in the low milliohm range, maybe half 1 milliohm, but they tend to get much larger as they get smaller in resistance. So as you get to the smaller resistance values, they become larger and take up more board space. But we've created a QFN package with a low resistance lead frame that allows for operation at very high continuous currents. far exceeding what would normally be seen with shunt resistors. The next benefit of magnetic current sensors over traditional shunts is functional isolation. Magnetic current sensors do not measure voltage or touch the conductor. Allegro magnetic sensors provide inherent functional isolation due to this non-contact sensing method. The Hall element is electrically isolated from the primary current path, preventing high voltages from reaching the sensing circuitry and ensuring safe operation. Shunt solutions suffer when voltage spikes occur. Positive and negative voltage spikes occur when MOSFETs are switching due to parasitic inductance. We are immune from that as we don't measure the voltage. We're measuring the magnetic field, which is proportional to the current. And so your output is much cleaner and separated from those issues.
Okay, so far we've covered four out of our list of advantages of magnetic current sensors over traditional shunt resistor circuits. Let's resume and cover the remaining two advantages on our list, starting with the advantage of better CMTI. And for the sake of those in our audience unfamiliar with the term, CMTI stands for Common Mode Transient Immunity.
Yes, so we have better CMTI than traditional circuits. Typically with op-amp circuits, they ring due to their lower common mode rejection ratio. They are not separated from the switching voltage, the DVDT, and so they tend to have this ringing. You'll see here, these are two side-by-side screenshots. On the left, you'll see common mode transient response, which shows the performance of our device in blue versus others, which have glitches and noisance due to the low CMRR. And so this is something that in a switching circuit, a pulse width modulated circuit, or a motor driver circuit measuring in line, you'll have to do some blanking in order to avoid reacting and measuring during this ringing time. With ours, obviously, because we're not measuring voltage, this is not an issue. We're immune to this common mode transient issue. On the right-hand side, you'll see current step response. Again, op-amps ring due to shunt inductance. Voltage is equal to DIDT times L. So the parasitic inductance in the shunt resistor creates this ringing as well. And so again, we're immune to this, which provides a cleaner response, which you'll see in red on the right-hand side. Another piece is that commonly for motor applications or general current sensing applications with PWMing signals, current sensing with shunts and op-amps will be done on the low side, which only allows partial information when current is flowing through this leg of the half-bridge circuit. And so you'll get not only an incomplete version of the current sensing signal, but you'll have the PWMing shown in the voltage. And so you can see on the top side here, that's reflected in the V low side measurement. So you have this signal which has information you do not want to be measuring that you'll have to account for in your MCU. And it also requires that you sample at the correct time to actually get the information that you need. So you have to sample, you know, when the current is actually flowing through this leg of the half bridge. And you can see with our devices, you can measure without issue in line with the actual load. In this case, it's an inductor or motor. And so current can be measured directly without concern for the actual PWMing of the voltage signal.
Ben, comparing those two circuit diagrams really helps me understand the two different approaches. Thanks for that great explanation. Ben, thanks for stepping through each of those aspects of magnetic current sensors and how they offer advantages over traditional shunt resistor circuits. Now, can you talk about some of the sensor devices from Allegro Microsystems that our audience can use to replace shunt resistor circuits?
This slide gives an overview of ACS71240, which is a cost-effective Hall-based current sensor designed as a shunt alternative. Specifically, it's available in the 12 contact QFN package. We call it the EX package, which is 0.6 milliohms and a 3x3 QFN. So a comparable alternative, which could save space on customers' PCBs when compared to the equivalent shunt-based current sensing circuit. It's available in 5 and 3.3 volts. It has a bandwidth of 120 kilohertz. This product is available at Mauser. We have material in stock available for sampling, as well as evaluation boards, which are available at Mauser. Additionally, the ACS71240 offers an overcurrent fault pin for fast detection of overcurrent conditions. The next product here is ACS37220, which is our highest power density 200 amp current sensor, ideal for applications which require high efficiency due to the 0.1 milliohm conductor resistance. This part is also in a QFN package, slightly larger than ACS71240, and that is understandable when considering the significantly reduced conductor resistance from 0.6 to 0.1 here. This is a 4x4 millimeter QFN as opposed to the 3x3 millimeter QFN, and at Allegro we call this the EZ package. So that's the difference between the two QFNs that we offer. Both are functionally isolated products for common mode voltages or isolation voltages up to 100 volts RMS. And this part is also available on Mauser, as well as evaluation boards are available there as well.
That was a great technology discussion, Ben. I know I learned a lot. Could you take a moment now to summarize why engineers should consider magnetic current sensors?
Yes, so to summarize the benefits of magnetic current sensors, we've given three quick bullet points here. Magnetic current sensors save space and component count due to the integration. We reduce filtering components and lower power dissipation, so there's less of a need for low-pass filtering. That's all integrated into our devices. And we offer very low resistance lead frame devices, conductor devices, which have benefit for efficiency over shunt resistors. And we also offer better common mode transient immunity and response than traditional shunt resistor circuits. We also add functional isolation to a circuit up to 100 volts RMS.
Before we sign off today, we want to thank our sponsor, Mauser Electronics. If you're looking to purchase any of these great Allegro Microsystems products, please head over to Mauser.com to help them continue to support educational presentations like this one. And join us again next time on Tech Chat, where we chat with leading experts like Ben Damkroger from leading technical innovators like Allegro Microsystems, who are changing the world every day.